Secretary of State, and we basically want to talk about, you know, the what's going on in terms of rebuilding Puerto Rico. Not so much rebuilding, but possibly making something better out of this catastrophe. What is the administration doing in that sense? And, you know, what is the thought process behind, yeah, we're getting the electricity back up, but are we making it better? Are we making it sustainable? What's going on, you know, in terms of that?
Well, there are always opportunities. And thank you for the opportunity to join you today. And as we plan our path forward, a lot of opportunities arise, and this is like when you are rebuilding a home, you want to do it in an efficient manner, so it's energy efficient, and you're not just going to rebuild it the same way, you'll try to do it better. And probably it's the best time and the best opportunity that you have a chance to do that. So in that sense, we were in a need for years and maybe decades of rethinking our electric power authority. We need a resilient system. We need a system that's efficient, that is sustainable. And when I say efficient, that means that you can get energy at a fair price when you compare it to other jurisdictions. And if we're talking about business, one of the major challenges and concerns that any business owner faces in the island is the cost of energy. We were recalling those times that where I was heading the tourism company, and every time you talk to a hotel investor, they will have energy cost as the first line, first item, which makes it hard to compete. And in a property like this, like the convention center, probably puts you in a disadvantageous position when you compete vis-a-vis Florida, Orlando, Miami, or major convention destinations like Las Vegas, where you have energy costs which are probably half of what you need to pay here.
So in that rethinking of the power company, is it finally going to be a possibility to fully integrate renewable energy, solar, wind, and all other alternatives that are perhaps less costly than fossil fuel?
When we had President Trump visit us a few weeks ago, President came down, and behind him came various cabinet members. Amongst them was Secretary Perry, who used to be governor of Texas, a good friend of mine. And President left with the governor, and I stayed with Secretary Perry and with a PREPA director. And we took, and the EPA director, and we took a close look at our grid, at the condition of the grid, and what are the opportunities for the grid. And the secretary was very sensible, and we did request a technical assistant from the Department of Energy, and they are here with us. And it is about having energy, especially power plants, whereby we can rely on P3s, and it's a great chance where we partner with the private sector and have the capacity not only to use clean fuels, but to use the sun, the energy that we have available because of our condition in the Caribbean, the wind, the trade winds that are with us. And certainly those are sustainable solutions that we need to have as an energy source for the island. So in terms of rebuilding our grid, it's about being more efficient. We are bringing a lot of energy from the south to the north, whereby you lose in heat probably 10 to 15%. So inefficient. And who pays it at the end? There's a waste basket there called Hosted Energía,
the energy adjustment,
where all those charges and inefficiencies are paid and billed to the consumers, to the businesses. So it's about time that we flexibilize the way we produce and consume energy. So in that sense, Governor Rosselló just recently, and co-signed with him an executive order, whereby he is ordering prepa, that all we flexibilize and make it more flexible if you have, let's say, power arrangement with a net metering, you have solar power panel.
Is that finally going to happen, the net metering?
So it's and the happening. And what we have now is something similar to the wheeling, whereby if you have solar panels, you can consume the energy that you produce. That was not the case. You can consume it, store it, and that way get kind of the grid or wheel it. Before there was the net metering, where you sold
it,
the energy at 8 cents, and then you bought back the difference at 21, 22 cents.
Right.
That's not a good deal for no one. Nevertheless, it was still efficient because the ROI, the return on investment, was close to 60 months, 5 years. So even then, it was a good payback. But now, with the executive order, we'll be able to produce and do like a microgrid.
Okay.
And
How quickly? Because time is also important.
It's done. So by executive order, the governor has allowed that.
So I can start as soon as.
So that's why I got a call last night from a major shipper in the island that's bringing Tesla batteries, which are very efficient energy storage wall packs to Vieques. So that is happening as we speak.
So that should be the first town that should see this.
I remember Vice President Dole, Clinton saying that Vieques is the perfect spot to have a green island in the States. And I believe they have the winds, they have the solar.
And they have the need because they're off the island.
Yeah,
sure.
So I think if we can have a showcase, what better than Vieques, and that could be a driver for the economy, and they could bring new industries and have a lower energy cost as an attractive for building new businesses and better jobs in the island.
Now, one last question on another topic. How is the government working with the small and mid-sized business that is currently maybe closed, maybe considering never reopening because there's no energy? I mean, that's certainly a concern, and it could be devastating for the economy. I know that the Department of Economic Development and Commerce is working on certain programs, but this has a sense of urgency.
Oh, certainly.
So what is happening with that segment?
The major obstacle right now is energy. If you're going to reopen a business, you need telecom, you need internet, you need a telephone, you need wireless, and you need energy to open your stores, or even if it's out of your own home. So energy is very important. What we've done together, government together with PREPA and Economic Development Secretary, is to recognize and identify clusters that are critical. So we make sure that we energize those areas, and that includes Atorre and major business centers where you have lots of small businesses there. And certainly SBA is bringing part of the initial package that Governor Rosselló had approved, and we are awaiting the Senate and the President's signature or approval. Those $4.9 billion,
which is going to the floor today, right?
It's going to the floor, and many are accessible or are destined to small business owners and SBA loans. So
that should be quick.
That should give some traction, which allows and makes up a little bit of the losses certainly incurred. And we have a strong insurance market, so many of the business interruption and other claims should allow to at least mitigate a little bit of this impact on small businesses.
One last question. How satisfied are you, one little over a month after the storm has hit, with the progress that the island has made? Certainly, some people are saying that day 32 is the same as day one.
We've moved a long way. We got school children attending school. We have our airport running strong. We got our port open for cruise ships. We got our first arrivals this week. We got our airport bringing in our tourists and merchandise. Our ports are getting back to normal. We just I just heard from Trump Crowley that he's moving a record amount of containers and through the island. So I think today's better than yesterday, and tomorrow's going to be better than today. It's been a very hard blow to the island. I've never before experienced the whole island under hurricane force, you know, category 5. So but we are resilient, we're strong, and we'll get back, you know, stronger than before. So like we started, we should get a better energy grid. Mm-hmm. You should be better prepared for any new storm that hits us.
You're preparing a book?
And
lesson book?
Let me tell you, we had an exercise with the War College back in March, and they had a scenarios where you had a category 5 hurricane hit you, then 4 days after that you got another hurricane category 3 hit you, then you had a dirty bomb that went into the Centro Medico. You said this is not gonna ever happen, but it happened. We didn't have the dirty bomb, but we had a dam that almost collapsed, and it's been a test, so it's a textbook for the future. Mm-hmm. And so we get ready.
Good. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.